Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. You may remember that recently there's been sort of a theme in terms of central banks accumulating more gold, you know, more than likely importing it or repatriating it to the reserves. But we have a little different story this time with the government of Sudan, where they have gold revenues at $5 billion, but let's find out exactly what that contains. Yes, this comes to us from Al Sharq Al Alsat, and this is some news from the Arab world here, and this is for the Sudanese government, that they estimate the gold revenues of $5 billion, which is a pretty good sum, but it's how they're producing it rather than importing it. So the Sudanese government said that the annual production of gold ranges between 120 to 200 tons, with revenues estimated at $5 billion in U.S. currency. It revealed that the number of workers in the mining sector amounts to around 5 million. So that's pretty amazing. Minister of Energy and Mines Adil Ali Ibrahim said that the sector, which he described as one of the country's most productive after the decline of agricultural and industrial production, is in dire need of urgent policies to tackle pending problems. He noted that the government's absent from mining region. Addressing a conference on mining in Sudan, he remarked that the central bank has ceased purchasing gold, adding that the Sudanese Mineral Resources Company Limited has gained access to this field. Part of the revenues has been allocated for domestic production and will be collected by the company. The government will not allow any foreign firm to work in remaining mines, except for a Russia firm that is operating under a previous agreement, said Ibrahim. Sadiq Tawar, a member of the Sovereignty Transitional Council, spoke of conflicts among local communities because the mining sector is linked to a corruption and oppression of the former regime. Tawar called for enacting regulations that preserve workers' rights in order to overcome tensions in these communities. He accused mining companies, which are owned by members of the former regime, of seeking to cause tension to enrich themselves. But you know, I do think it's quite telling that they are producing so much gold there, and they are kicking out these foreign companies, and so they're not importing or buying any gold from outside sources. They're producing it locally, within country. I think this tells us. I think this basically tells us that, you know, there's more gold to be found and to be mined, and that many of these nations that do that are keeping it to themselves. You know, China is relatively secret. There's a lot we don't know exactly about their gold production or what have you. They are considered one of the largest gold producers in the world. And my guess is they're probably keeping a lot of that. But as you saw in a previous video as well, they're also importing gold from the United States. So it is fascinating to see how this plays out and where it is. But nonetheless, it is interesting and fascinating. You find gold, you keep it. That's exactly what this nation is doing, the Sudanese government and Sudan. And so we'll see. I just hope that, as it was discussed in this article, that they will mine responsibly and to be able to accumulate this gold without causing any undue harm to their citizenry. But it is fascinating holding on to gold. That's what we do when we purchase gold. And some of us out there in this community actually go out and find our own gold too, which is pretty cool. It would be kind of an interesting and fun thing to try sometime, to go out and actually mine for gold, as we've seen. But there you have it. Very interesting news. So post your thoughts below about the Sudanese government and their gold revenues. And what do you think about this story? Do you think we're going to see a trend of more nations accumulating gold, either by mining it themselves or buying it or repatriating it? Would like to extend a multitude of gratitude to you all for watching and encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.